This exercise consists of three parts. Let's start with the first part, which is about calculating the width of a slit in a diffraction setup. A laser beam with wavelength 632.8 nanometers in vacuum falls normally on a vertical slit of width A. The diffraction pattern is observed on a screen placed perpendicular to the laser beam at a distance of 1.5 meters from the slit. Let L be the linear width of the central fringe. The diffraction angle theta corresponding to a dark fringe of order n is given by sine theta equals n lambda over a, where n is a non-zero integer. For small angles in radians, take tangent theta approximately equal to sine theta, which is approximately equal to theta.
In all the following questions, the diffraction angles are small. Number 1. Describe the diffraction pattern observed on the screen. On the screen, we observe alternate bright and dark spots or fringes on both sides of a central bright fringe. The central fringe is the most intense and has a width double that of the other bright fringes. And the fringes are extended along a direction orthogonal to the slit.
Let's move to part 2. Write the relation among A, theta 1, and lambda. In the beginning of the question, we have sine theta n equals n lambda over A, where n is a non-zero integer. Now, theta 1 is the angle of diffraction at the center of a dark fringe. Then, let's replace n by 1. So, we will get sine theta 1 equals 1 times lambda over a. But theta 1 is a small angle. Then let's replace sine theta 1 by theta 1. So this is going to be theta 1 equals lambda over a. Let's move to part 3. Determine the relation among a, lambda, l, and d. Look at this figure. D is the distance between the slit and the viewing screen. L is the width of the central fringe. Now, look at the blue right-angled triangle. Tangent theta 1 equals L over 2 over D, which is equal to L over 2D. Again, the diffraction angles are small, then tangent theta 1 is approximately equal to theta 1. Now, theta 1 equals L over 2D. Replace theta 1 by lambda over A. This is going to be lambda over A equals L over 2D. Therefore, L equals 2 lambda D over A. This is the relation among A, lambda, L, and D.
Number 4. Calculate the width of the used slit, knowing that the length of the central bright fringe equals 6.3 millimeters. Using this relation, L equals 2 lambda D over A, then A equals 2 lambda D over L. Lambda D and L should be expressed in the same unit. Lambda is given in nanometer, so lambda should be multiplied by 10 to the power minus 9 to become in meter. L is given in millimeters, so L must be multiplied by 10 to the power minus 3 to become in meters. Therefore, A equals 3.0 times 10 to the power minus 4 meters equals 0.30 millimeters.
Focus, please. This is important.
Let's move to part B. It is about controlling the thickness of a thin wire. A manufacturer of thin wires intends to regulate the diameter of his product. He uses the same setup mentioned in part A, but he replaces the slit by a thin vertical wire. He observes the phenomenon of diffraction on the screen. Look at figure 2. This is the thin vertical wire, and the laser beam falls on this wire. This is the diffraction pattern observed on the screen. It is similar to the diffraction pattern observed in part A of this exercise. Now, For D equals 2.60 meters, he obtains a central fringe of constant linear width, whose value is 3.40 millimeters. Number 1. Calculate the value of the diameter A1 of the wire at the illuminated point. In a previous slide, we obtained the relation between L, lambda, D, and A. So let's use this relation. A1 equals 2 lambda D over L. Plugging in the numbers gives the value of the width or the diameter of this wire, which is equal to 9.68 times 10 to the power minus 4 meters or 0.968 millimeters.
Number 2. The manufacturer illuminates the wire at different positions under the same previous conditions. Specify the indicator that allows the manufacturer to check whether the diameter of the wire is constant. Using this relation A1, or the diameter of the wire equals to lambda D over L. Lambda and D have the same values, or lambda times D remains constant. Then, if the manufacturer measures the same value of L at different positions, then A must be constant. Therefore, the indicator is the linear width of the central bright fringe.
Let's move to the third part of this exercise, which is about calculating the refractive index of water. We place the whole setup of part A in water whose refractive index is unwater. We obtain a new diffraction pattern. We find that for D equals 1.5 meters and A equals 0.30 millimeters, the linear width of the central fringe is 4.7 millimeters. Number 1. Calculate the wavelength lambda prime of the laser light in water. Let's use the relation between L, lambda, D, and A. Lambda prime equals A, L2 over 2D. Plugging in the numbers gives the value of the wavelength of this laser beam in water. This wavelength equals 470 times 10 to the power minus 9 meters.
2a. Determine the relation among lambda, lambda prime, and water. We know that the wavelength of light in a certain medium is given by its speed in the same medium over its frequency. So in air, the wavelength of the light is denoted by lambda, and the speed of light is denoted by c. So lambda equals c over its frequency nu. In water, the wavelength of the light becomes lambda prime, and its speed becomes v, but the frequency does not change and remains nu. But v is given by c over n water. So replace v by c over n water, then lambda prime becomes c over nu times n water. C over nu is the wavelength of light in air. So we can write lambda prime equals lambda over n water. Part B. Deduce the value of n water. Using the previous relation, n water can be written as lambda over lambda prime. Lambda equals 6 to 3.8 nanometers given, and lambda prime equals 470 nanometers proved or calculated before. So n water equals 1.33. n water has no unit.